Okay, I'll start. Hello, good afternoon. My name is José Santos, and my presentation is about the Agile Innovation Model. Before starting, I want to present my apologies for my English. I have some difficulty speaking English, but I will give my best, and I hope you can understand my explanation. Okay, this presentation has six topics. First, I will make a brief overview of the importance of the Agile concept. In the second topic, I will talk about some reasons for organizations to adopt the Agile concept. In the next topic, I will talk about the difference between creativity and innovation. The topic number four is about the type of innovation, some proposals to classify innovation. The point number five is about the Agile Innovation Framework. Finally, I will talk about the Agile concept adopted by the marketing department, which it's an example of how Agile can contribute to organization innovation. So let's begin. Today, almost everyone agrees that organizations are under more pressure. This pressure comes from different forces, from economic force, social force, demographic force, technological force, and even political force. The environment changes rapidly, and sure, it does not exist. The knowledge of the happens tends not to be simple. And also the interpretation of things is not easy because there is a lot of information, and some of it this information does not correspond to reality. So the organizations also need to make the difference between what is true and what is not true. Of course, with the pandemic situation, this pressure has increased even more. In addition to this external force, political, economic, social, etc., organizations still have to manage internal force like personal life cycle, personal interest, motivation, and so on. I often say it's a joke, but I think perhaps it's true. I often say that the biggest problem for organizations is the people. Without the people, organizations are more easy to manage. Without the people, organizations don't have problem, more or less. But the organizations have people. And the organization need to be better with less resource and more quickly. So with these market trends, organizations need to adapt Agile. So this is an opportunity to adopt Agile because with Agile, the organization expect to have faster decisions, smart decisions, increase productivity, decrease risk, efficient use of resource, increase attraction and retention of customers. All these points I think is important, but the last point is crucial. Without customers, there are no companies, not exist organizations. The Agile concept in its manifest as mentioned, the importance of engaging customers for better results. After all, the customer should be the center of the organization. This is a basic principle, but often in practice it is forgotten. All process, everything the company wants to streamline should be the customer's perspective. So the customers must be the center of the company, must be the center of the organization. On the other hand, some companies attract the clients with beautiful marketing communication, but they can't retain the clients because the organization can't flow the evolution of the customer. The company is not agile in internal change. So fast decision, smart decision, and so on, this point present are not new. I think it's not new. This is what any organization wants before or after, with or without Agile. So I think the difference between Agile and other things perhaps don't be in the goals, but in the way to get there. So casual concept can be the way to transform the organization work, with create small parts, small projects, short work cycles, flexibility, and develop team spirit. In the adoption of the Agile concept, there are a number of factors that tends to influence its success. These factors can be grouped in four groups: management and organizational factors, people factors, process factors, and technology factors. In first group, one indirect factor, very important, is motivation. Motivation is influenced by organizational culture, management style, and of course, reward system. I still highlight at this point the resistance to change, which is often a reason for not have success. In second group, customer relationship reinforces the importance to design the process oriented to the customer and the importance to listening the customer. This process must be short. Design short process is important. If the organization have long process, it's very important to study the possibility to divide, for example, in three, four sub-process. In technology factors, the organization must use tools that make everyday life more easy, and it is important that these tools maximize the potential of the Agile concept. When the organization manages these critical factors, it becomes more easy to adopt the Agile concept. Now, we know some factors which can contribute to have an Agile adoption with the success. The question is, what is Agile? When you search about Agile, you can get different perceptions. As we can see in this table, you have three different ways to look at Agile. In one way, Agile you see as a methodology defined for other people. I will say this vision perhaps represents something more formal. In second view, Agile as a mindset, as a mental attitude to obtain success. The last view incorporates some aspects of the others and assigns an important role to the person as part of the team. The person and the team must work together. So this is the first way, Agile as a movement. So when we look at the first view, we can say that Agile is a movement that combines mindset and practice with a set of values. There are four and 12 principles defined in the Agile manifest. The practice tends to be supported by tools, frameworks, methodologies such as Scrum, Kanban, and so on. And the challenge of organization is not just being agile, but doing agile, incorporate this value, this principle, and practice. Before speaking about innovation, let's differentiate creativity from innovation. The organization needs to have creativity to have innovation, in my point of view. I think the creativity is the base of innovation. The organizations need to generate ideas with creativity. So it's a challenge to the company, to the organization, have creativity. The manager and the different managers needs to guide the organization to creativity. But an organization can have creativity but don't have innovation, because between creativity and innovation, the organization needs to be able to transform the idea generated by creativity into something that is accepted by the market, for example, a product. But that's not enough to get innovation. This product, this service, this innovative process need to have an acceptable cost to the client, external client or internal client. So we need to have creativity to have an idea, and we need to transform this idea in innovation with acceptable cost. An idea can result in an innovation or in invention. Invention it isn't useful, if it isn't not accepted by the market, it's just an invention. Possibly that's why Professor Hiro, in Portuguese, Professor Pardal, as an inventor and not an innovator. He has many inventions, but with no utility and no market. So I think the challenge is to be able to introduce the Agile concept in the process of transforming an idea to increase the probability of success. A company adopting the Agile concept decreases the development time of the idea, the validation of the idea by marketing, decrease the time, for example, to perform tests on the product, and so on. So I think the possibility to be overtaken by the competition is smaller. Usually, when you think to innovation, there is a tendency to think about the product. However, innovation can exist in process, in the relationship with the client, in the way of distributing a product, in the way the company is managed. In this table, we can see the different types of innovation according to the Oslo Manual. which considers the existence of four types of innovation. So we have product innovation, where a good or service is new or improved. We have process innovation, where we can get we can have a new or important improved production or delivery form. Another type of innovation can be in marketing area, where we can have innovation, for example, in the way to place the product or the way the client to pay the product. Finally, you have organizational innovation. It's possible to introduce, for example, a new organizational model. Of course, the organization can innovate in one or more years. In this slide, we have a different form to classify the innovation. As you can see, the big difference between this classification and the previous are in the product innovation, because in this model, the service innovation is another type of innovation. Also, another type of innovation is the production innovation, the way to make the product or the service. Also, in this classification, we can see management as a type of innovation. I think this classification is better, in my opinion, because it opens the horizon for the organization. The classification itself, I think it's not the most important thing. The most important thing, in my point of view, is the vision of the organization to the areas where the organization can seek to create a dynamic of innovation. So there are different perspectives on type of innovation. This is another model. From my point of view, this model is most complex, most compelled. It's important from the point of view of the organization that we take a model. The organization must take a model and try to integrate the agile concept and analyze how it can contribute to create and maintaining an innovation dynamic in the organization. Of course, this is only possible if the company has a strategy that involves innovation and consequently an organization culture oriented to innovation. The organization must apply agile innovation process as having three principles goals. First of all, the organization must be fast because it's important to reduce the time to market. Second rule, the organization must be flexible. It's important to have capacity to react, have capacity to change, have capacity to adapt to external conditions and internal conditions too, because the internal environment can also change. Third rule, customer must come first. This is important to have a centric view of the client. Incorporate client participation at the innovation process is very important. In this image, we can see three large areas where innovation can exist. The three areas are configuration, offering, and experience. These three areas group 10 types of innovation. So in this model, you can see 10 types of innovation. And 10 types of innovation are the profit model, how the company make money, the network, how the company use connection with others to create value to the client, structure, how the company make alignment of the talent and the assets. Another type of innovation is the process, how to do the things, how, which methods do you need to do better for the client. Another type of innovation is in the product performance, define what features and functionality the product must have. You have a product system, define what complementary products and service the company must have. The company can innovate in complementary products and make the difference, for example. Service, what support the company offer before, what type of support company have before and after the purchase of the client. Another type of innovation, it's in channel. How the company can innovate in the way to offer and deliver the product to or service to customers and users. Finally, we have the brand. You must define how the company makes the mental representation of the product, of the service to all stakeholders. How can our decision is how can we innovate in brand? And the last innovation in this model, it's the customer engagement. How the company define how and company can create and use relationships with clients. This type of innovation is about customer engagement, but I think today the company can have a different type of engagement, not only customer engagement, but also, for example, partner engagement, employee engagement, and I think here you can innovate too. To finish this topic about type of innovation, I want to present this another view. This another way to classify innovation is based on two dimensions. So we can have innovation that is new to the organization, but it's not new to the market. Or we can have innovation that is also new to the market, and of course, it's new to the market, is new to the company, is new to the organization. Because the second type of innovation tends to be more complex, it's possible that agile concept generate a greater dynamics. Another way to look to agile is see agile as an innovation for the organization. When organization adapt agile concept, the organization is innovating. This innovation, it's also a challenge for the organization because it's normal exists resistance to the change. So the company can also need to define in which part or parts of the organization it will integrate the agile concept. Which part or parts? So there are a simple question, but I think the response is not so simple. The question is, should the agile concept be introduced in all parts of the organization at the same time or step by step? If we go step by step, how to set priorities? I think this is a strategic decision and it is very important. Not all ideas are good ideas. And during the process of transforming ideas into innovation, many of the ideas are being discarded. The organization needs to generate ideas in a quantity to resolve these decrees. In this slide, we have some stakeholders who can contribute with ideas to the organization. It's important that the company develop mechanisms with agile concept supported by internal and external stakeholders to obtain ideas. So the agile concept can help the company and the organization to obtain ideas. Everything is possible to contribute to obtain ideas by the organization. The clients, the sales force, the point of sales, employers, and so on. Another question, very important, is if the ideas are possible to materialize and if they are framed at the right time. The right time is very important, and Agile can contribute to this. For example, a product with was launched not in right time. Apple in the past launched a product called Newton. Newton, which has a personal digital assistant, has failed possibly because it was too soon for this product. Today, almost everybody uses a personal digital assistant. Smartphone is a personal digital assistant with the telephone and internet. But in this time when Apple has launched the product, has too soon. So I think the moment when organization innovate is very important. And here we can get some stakeholders to have input from ideas to the organization can innovate. As I said, to have innovation, it is necessary to have creativity, but also the ability to conceptualize the idea and, of course, to develop the idea. The Agile concept tends to be present a lot from the perspective of development. As you can see in this framework, Agile is present as a contribution to develop the idea. But if you want the whole process from creativity to innovation to be fast and flexible, we have to look from the Agile concept to be present at all times in all process, not only in develop phase, but in all the phase. So, in my opinion, this framework can be adapted to incorporate the Agile concept, not only in the developed phase, but as I said, in our process. Okay, here we have another presentation. In this presentation, Agile concept, it's present from the stage of generating ideas to the moment when innovation is validated by the market. During the process of transforming the idea into innovation, we have different steps, such for example, validation of the marketing concept in case innovation occurs in the product. But in all these steps, it is intended that the Agile concept is also present, not only in development, but in the different phases. So you can see you have Agile in the phase of creativity, phase of generate ideas, in the phase of transforming the ideas in innovation, and in the phase of innovation. The Agile concept can facilitate the transformation process between creativity and innovation. And in this representation, also you can see the Agile concept base. These ways are dynamic structure, sample process, fast decision, collaboration, autonomy, consumer-centric or customer-centric, adaptability, and flexibility. During the process, the tools, the methodologies should be chosen according to what we think it's better. This is why we can see companies who use design thinking, Scrum, Kanban, and so on. Everything must be in tune for efficiency and effectiveness and competitive advantage. So with these 3 points, it's possible to have an agile organization. In this image, we can see that companies in this study, you can see that companies that adopt Agile in their innovation process achieve greater sophistication in innovation management. We can see, you can also see that the average number of companies that can get innovation success is higher in companies that have adopted the Agile concept compared to companies that have not adapted the Agile concept. So this study indicates that companies with adopt Agile concept tends to get more success and more output of innovation sophistication. Now I will talk about and project some information about Agile concept adoption by marketing department to present some considerations. In this chart, it's possible to see that what are the main benefits that a company seeks to obtain when it adopts the Agile concept in the marketing department. The first reason is that a company that adopts the Agile concept obtain great flexibility to change the shoes direction. The second reason is related to increasing the company's capacity to better define the priorities of the business. I think the last reason in the graph is last, but I think it's still important, because it is about the resource the optimization. The lack of resources like financial resource, economical resource, human resource, or even technological resource is one of the big problems of the companies. As someone said, which time we have to do double with half the resource. So for me is a reason very important and a good reason to adopt Agile concept, optimize use of the resource. In this chart, we can analyze how long the companies have adopted the Agile concept. Most of the companies survive adopted the Agile concept between 1 or 2 years. The difference between the group of companies that adopt between 3 and 5 years is only 1 percentage point. And on the other hand, 25% of companies are in startup phase, 7%, or adopt less than a year. So there are companies at a different level of maturity in the adoption of the Agile concept. In this study, we don't have elements about any company that have abandoned the Agile concept. And if so, why? I think they would be important elements to know not only the success adoption, but in this study, we don't have this information. In this chart, you can see the main methodology used by companies in the marketing department. And what stands out is the fact that companies combine different methodology in face of needs all at the marketing department. So you can have different methodology in the department of marketing. Finally, this is the last chart. It's possible to see that the pandemic situation impacted on agile adoption in marketing. We can see that 38% of companies said that the pandemic situation has accelerated plans to adopt the agile concept in the marketing department. But most company, 45%, said it had no impact and the plans took place as planned before the pandemic situation. In this slide, we can see the Agile manifest values adapt to the marketing. So this demonstrates how the Agile concept is not limited to IT. From the perspective of marketing, the Agile values are validate learning over opinions and conventions, customer-focused collaboration, adaptive and interactive campaigns, the process of customer discovery, flexible versus rigid planning, responding to change overflowing a plan, and finally, many small experiments over a few large bets. This is the Agile manifest values adapt to the marketing. Also, the Agile principles have been adapted and adopted. Some principles are personal-centered, like, for example, don't be afraid to fail, just don't fail the same way twice. So here we have 11 principles. One of the principles I would like to mention is the last. But all are important. Last, why? Because simplicity is base of agile concept. But all are important. For example, one of the most frequent complaints of marketing is that it is not in tune with sales. There is a principle for this. Great marketing requires close alignment with business, sales, and development. So, with this principle applied to the Agile marketing principles, the Department of Marketing can get more collaboration from sales and sales from marketing. So, to finish my presentation, I will do some final considerations. First, Agile concept is important to have agility organizations. There is no consensus what is Agile is, but Agile exists. Agile can act on a different type of innovation. Agile can be an innovation for an organization. Innovation for an organization. Agile can promote creativity. Agile can be present in the innovation process. Agile can contribute to increase the success and sophistication of innovation. Agile is not just for IT projects. And different Agile methodologies and tools can be used. So I finished my presentation. I think you have questions. 1 minute, please, to see. Okay, the question is it's about how to open people's minds about innovation and Agile. I think one way to especially in big companies, and one way to not have this problem is have the people involved in the process. The people must know why and what the companies want to get when make Agile adoption, and what the people, what are the rule, the people rule, I'm sorry, the people rule in the process. What the people want to know is what is my rule in the process when Agile comes to my company. Because when Agile comes to a company, when I say Agile, I say another things, for example, the adoption of a new technology, you have the resistance to change. And you need to manage this resistance to change. So one way to manage this have the collaboration of the people, it's to involve the people in the process. Explain to the people how we can get more productivity, for example, with the new reality, with the new paradigm. I hope I can answer to the question. Do you have more questions, please? I want to reinforce my apologies for my English. So we have here another question about following about co-creation process. People don't know about innovation. About innovation is, yes, I agree. One thing is the phase of creativity, and another thing is the phase of innovation. So you can get. Collaboration to people in the phase of, for example, in the phase of creativity, but you have, perhaps you can have some difficulties in the phase of innovation. This is a continued process. It's necessary to have the involvement of the people in all the process. So another question, how will you talk about why innovation is important and what all do you recommend? Okay, one thing today, the company can use, it's gaming. I think gaming can be a good opportunity to involve the people can develop some games, some participation of the people, of the persons in the company to participate in this game. And in this game, you can have an object is talk about what is innovation, what is the difference between innovation and, for example, innovation and in products and innovation in the sorry innovation in process. Sorry for delay. The process, I think innovation process is very difficult to change because the people want to make the same things. The people have the reasons to change. And if I have a product, I have a thing, I have a process that I do along the time in same way, why change? So you must involve, for example, use gaming for involve the people, involve the employees to have more to have less resistance to the change. Yes, I agree. When you reward in the game can see as a way to motivate the people, but the company must choose what type of the game and not not when I ask the people when I say game, I don't say game in computer. I say game which involves personal directly in the games more without in the traditional games without computer. I think we have time.
Well, I believe that there's no further questions. So I don't know, Professor, maybe you can wrap it up and
okay.
Just close the session.
In this slide I project, you have the bibliography to support this slide.
Yes, maybe then afterwards we can provide this information to the
okay.
participants, and if they have further questions, maybe they can reach you and maybe send an email or something if you agree.
Okay, no
problem. We can do that afterwards. So if there's no further questions, then, well, thank you all for being
okay.
here. I don't know if you want to say something else.
No, I am present. My apologies for my English.
Never mind. We appreciate your presence. And we thank everybody for coming. And we'll see you next session. Thank
okay.
you very much. And have a good afternoon.
Okay. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye-bye.